फ्रेंड्स, सो दिस इज हियर फ्रॉम वेयर वी लेफ्ट इन आर लास्ट लास्ट डेमो. सो वी आर स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम हियर. व्हाट वी विल डू, वी विल गो बैक टू द विजुअलाइजेशन पैन एंड वी विल रिमूव द वैल्यू ऑफ नॉर्थ अमेरिका सेल्स फ्रॉम हियर. एज वी रिमूव द वैल्यू, वी विल सी देर इज ओनली ग्लोबल सेल्स प्रेजेंट देयर एंड our line chart looks pretty simple. We are going to make it more complicated by adding filtering data being visualized. So in this demo we will learn about how we can use filter on the data being visualized. So this line chart representing global sales of video game buyers. Let's add some complexity to this chart. To begin with, let's click to the genre field. So here we are clicking with genre field. So genre field way over on the right and drag and drop into lesson control. So if we do drag and drop, or we just click here in some version, what you need to do, you just need to drag and drop this here in genre control. This in legend control of visualization pane. Well, the appearance of the chart change immediately. You have to just drag and drop from here to here in some version of Power BI. As I am clicking, it's taking its own in the lesson. So the visualization of the appearance of chart change immediately. And note for better, this is now really complicated. It's really hard to read chart. In a moment, you will see how to use filter in the visualization pane. For now, let's click on the focus mode icon on the top right, and this will allow us to explore the data in more detail. So we will just click on the focus mode. By hovering these lines, we can see the tooltip now. Includes our total sales for a given year appear on the top of the tooltip, and we have individual sales for each of the genre in that year. Do keep in mind that this is all global sales data you can see in visualization pane, that in Access we have a year, in legend we have a genre field, and in values we have the global sales. Clearly, this visualization is too messy to work with it meaningfully, So the way we are going to fix it by expanding the filter pane. Let's click to the back to the report on the top left, and we go and expand to filter pane here. If you go closely, you can see we have a collapsed version of filter pane. So we click on the expand arrow and filter panes will open here. This is a collapsed version. As we click on the expand arrow and filter panes appear, that filter panes include search dialog, this one, and then filters on the visual here. You can see those filters are specified in each of the field. So we have genre here, global sales, sum of global sales, and as well as year. And at the start of this process, each of these filter is set to the value all. This also, this also, this also. So let's click genre because we really need to simplify this chart, and the best way to do it is by filtering on the genre. So let's check on the filter type. So if we click on the filter type drop down will open, and there are three types of filter: advanced filtering, basic filtering, and top end. Let's start with basic filtering. As you can see, we can choose to select all. We can choose to select all to genre or only include a specific genre in which we are really interested in. At the bottom of the contacts, you can see the little checkbox which says requires single selection. Let's hover there, and you will see over the tooltip has some interesting insights. If we hover there, we see it only allow one item in the list to be selected, and Q&A will only show this page in search result if one of the items in the list is mentioned. So if we selected only single genre will be there selected. In addition, this also allowed Q&A feature. Q&A allows us to human readable search phrases. When we have this checkbox selected, Q&A will be only displayed this particular visualization in the output. If one of the item in list is mentioned, now we don't check this checkbox. Instead, we hover the visualization now by selecting few genres. So we are selecting action. We are not selecting select all. So we are selecting action. We are selecting adventure. And now come down. We are going to select, let's see, we are selecting a race, and we are selecting sports. So if we hover there, the tooltip also displays only those genre which we selected in filter menu. So now just clear the filter. We can now do this by see. First you see here, so if we want to read information about any particular year, we can easily read by 1982-2020 for these five games. So this is a very good feature of Power BI, where we can have multiple things, but we can have option of selecting only few. And you can see here that Power BI automatically taking the colors. We didn't took any setting for this. It is taking different colors for different games. So now just if we want to go and clear the filter here, so we can now do by click on this little icon over on the top right of the genre control. You can see there we currently have the genre selected that has a list of values. Clicking on the eraser reset the genre. So if we click this, it will reset the genre, and once again visual will become more cluttered. We could also click on the filter button, that is to prevent users of this report once it's published. So we can also use lock filter. So we can also click on the lock filter button to prevent users of this report once it's published from changing the filter selection. When it's done, you can't change the filter here. So for now we can just choose the hide filter. We can also have option for ascending or descending the filter from A to Z, means ascending or in the descending view. So we have filter control in this ways. Similarly, tooltip at the filter type tells us that this will allow our report readers to choose between basic, advanced and top end filter. We have explored basic filtering, now change with top end value from corresponding drop down. This will allow us to show top end values. Let's enter here and go to the top end value. So this will allow us to show top end values. Let's enter the value 5 into the input control. Here, we are entering only top 5 value. And what's interesting, we can filter top 5 values on different genre. So now we are going to drag and drop into by values control the global sales. So what we will do, we just simply drag and drop global sales here and we will click on apply filter. When we click on apply filter, this is going to show only top 5 values. That is the top 5 genre by global sales. See, you can see these are the top 5 genre of global sales. Let's go into the focus mode that will allow us to view these top 5 genre in little more detail. You can see by hovering on tooltip what these are. You can see by year it's showing top 5 genre. In 2003 it was action, platform, role-playing, shooter and sports. By clicking on this view, we can see in 1982 it was quite different. So we can see 2009 it was quite high, action genre was quite high, it was having the value of 139.36. So the tooltip also includes for the year. It's important to note that this top end filter is going to take into account top 5 genre by global sales across all years. As just little detail worth keeping in mind, we have now covered two out of the three filter. What left is advanced filtering, but we will come back to the later. So let's click on the little eraser. As we go and click on the little eraser to eliminate all of the filters on genre, let's take to the back to our cluttered visualization. Let's undo this by rid of the genre from legend. Replace any sales into values fields. So what we'll do, we'll remove it or we will click here. And now we add another value, JP sales. In the coming video, we are going to go ahead and construct the line chart in multiple series in for coming ahead. So what we'll do, we will just put JP sales here in visualization pan and we will explore the in more detail about JP sales and we will construct the line chart in multiple series in coming demo ahead. So this is all about from my side in this demo. I hope you clear how to use the filtering pan in Power BI for different values. Okay. Thank you so much.